My name is Framus Jack. I'm the president of Faithful Finance Church Worldwide. It all started back in 2014. I remember having a vision, and in that vision, I saw myself in a queue, like a long line, and I was like, God, this line is just too long. How long will it take? And this and that. I was just saying this stuff, and someone came, an elderly person wearing on white, and asked me to follow him. So while I was moving with him, we were moving through an highway, and the road was very smooth. And suddenly we get to a point, he told me that I should go through the bridge. And I started climbing the bridge. And I got to the end of the bridge. There was no more way. Everything I saw was a forest. And I looked back and I reached out to him. I screamed, I was like, why did you ask me to follow this way? I said, I'm like in the middle of nowhere. Everything I see right now is a forest. He said, yeah. He said, because you have been chosen to create a way in that forest for others to pass. And I look at the forest, man, it was a thick forest. And I turned back to ask him for the question. He disappeared, and that's how I woke up. Then I continued living my normal life. I didn't do anything about the vision. I didn't take it seriously. Then 2017, I had a vision. The Lord came and gave me scripture. And the Lord gave me Isaiah 57, verse 14. And when I opened it, he was talking about build up, clear the way, remove the obstacle for my people to pass, for the return of my people. And the word of the Lord came and confirmed to me that this scripture is to confirm the vision that was given to me 2014. Then fast forward, 2018, January 2018, I had a vision where a man came to me. He came to my church back then. I was still serving as a protocol, and asked me to come out, and he lay hands on me and told me many things, and said it's time for me to move, to go to the next place of my assignment. And later I found out that that man was actually Billy Graham. And the next month, which was February 2018, I had a vision, and I saw a man being honored like the president of America. But the vision I saw a casket. And I saw the White House of America, and I saw the American soldiers was carrying the casket, and they put him on the American presidential helicopter. And I was like, who is this great man that was honored this way? And the next thing, I saw some other part of the vision that revealed who this man was, that he was Billy Graham. The same man I saw a month before then that came to meet me in the vision and said, it's time. Then I woke up, and I still didn't do anything about the vision. I was just living my normal life. Then come July, ending of July, the Lord came to me and said, I'm going to give you an assignment. And he said, I want you to do a 40 days fasting. And in these 40 days, you're going to pray for people. He said, but I'm going to visit you every day and give you the name of each person and the problem they're going through for you to intercede for them. And I was like, well, I think I can do that. So August, I started the fasting and ended September. And till today, that became a mandate in the church that every August, we do our general fasting till date. We do it, and it's a lifetime thing for the church. And I remember few days rounding up, the Lord started speaking to me. Get your things. It's time. He said, go to US. When you get to US, I'll speak to you. So I was like, okay, God, am I coming back? Am I staying? God said, just go to US. When you get to US, I'll speak to you. So immediately I put up my things. A week after the end of the 40 days fasting, I left everything and I moved straight to the US. I remember getting to New York that night and I was like, God, I'm here, speak. And God said to me, go and sleep, you're tired. So I slept and the next morning I woke up. Now before then, during the 40 days fasting, I've been having series of visions about a place called Baltimore, Maryland. Now, I've never been to Baltimore, I've never been to Maryland before, but I keep having consistent vision that that's the place God is sending me to. And I have a friend who was in Baltimore at that time, so God keep using him to direct me the place I'm going in America. So when I got to New York, I remember I was on my way to Baltimore, where I had one of the strangest encounters. The angel of the Lord came to me in human form and spoke to me and said, welcome to America, that you're not going back. You're here for this, you're here for that. And he said so many things to me. And that is how I moved into America and the whole thing started from there. And I remember 2018, I had this strange encounter where I saw myself. I woke up in the morning, I wanted to go shower, and I saw myself. I have this standing mirror. Now, I looked at the mirror. Now, this was a physical encounter. I wasn't sleeping, I wasn't dreaming, it wasn't a trance. And I saw myself, it was like I was watching a movie. I saw myself in the mirror. I was in a place, and I was teaching young people concerning God. I was revealing the true image of God to them. And I saw blacks, I saw Asians, I saw whitey. And the next thing I saw, that I came out of the mirror, and I was like, God, what's this? And the Lord said, figure it out. So I started praying to know the nation that has these people. And the Lord revealed to me it's America. So fast forward, I came to America in 2020. The ministry started. And we did ministry for 2 years. Then God came again and said, it's time for the church to start. So we started the church. That's the brief, just a brief history of how it all started. Now, before I take us to the name Faith Refiners, I quickly want to bring this. 2019, September precisely, I had this strange encounter that defined the ministry. I was in a vision and I saw myself in the forest and I saw multitude of people in thousands, in millions. I saw them with chains on their legs, on their hands, on their necks. And I saw them begging and crying for freedom, crying for liberation. And I was angry in my spirit, seeing people being chained. And I just couldn't contain my anger in that vision. And I saw the slave master. And the moment the person saw me, the person disappeared. And I said, I'm going to trace you to anywhere you're going. And I also disappeared in that vision. And we both appeared in the graveyard. And to my greatest surprise, I saw multitude again in this same graveyard. I saw thousands and millions of people, same in the graveyard, with chains on their leg, chains on their hands, and chains on their neck, and crying and asking for liberation. And suddenly, I was asked a question, what have you come to do? And I remember in that vision, I was angry and I said, I have come to liberate these people, to deliver them, to set them free. And that's how I woke up. And when I woke up, the Lord said to me, get ready. That's the assignment you've been created for. To bring liberation to the multitude you see crying out there. He said, I've chosen you to be the one to undergo this task. And so that was what led to the 2020 Faith Refiners mandate that started. Then fast forward to the question, how the Faith Refiners name came up. I remember when we started the fellowship, it was the coming together of young people. When the Lord said, okay, it's time, I have to bring our people together. I remember the first thing we did, the Lord spoke to me about the land he taught me and asked me to gather 20 people and do a 40 days fasting. So I remember calling forth some young people and we came together and we did a 40 days fasting and prayer over the land of America, over the land of Maryland. And towards that, before that season, while the fellowship was going on, I remember someone called me and said, what name do we call this ministry? And I said, I don't know, call it any name. I said, I have no name for it. And I went back to God. I said, God, that's true. What's the name for this ministry? And I prayed and I went to bed. And I remember that night I had a vision where a scripture was given to me. And one of the sisters, who is now a pastor in the church, woke up with the same vision. So when she was sharing her vision with me, it aligns with the same vision I had that same night. And when we opened the scripture and we read the scripture, it was talking about the refining. And that's when God started speaking. So she heard the word, I heard the word, and by the time we brought the name together, it came about with the word Faith Refiners. So it was a confirmation of two visions that brought the confirmation of the name Faith Refiners. And I remember after getting that name, I said, God, every church has a logo. What is the logo of this church? And while I was praying, I fell into a trance and I saw a torchlight, like the Olympic torch. And I saw it burning and shining at the top level. And I came out of the trance and the Lord started speaking to me. That is the logo of Faith Refiners. That is what Faith Refiners stand for. To bring the light into darkness. And the Lord keep emphasizing how light shines in darkness and the darkness could not comprehend it. He said, I've raised this ministry to bring light into the land. So ever since then, the logo came with the light. And we have been projecting that light anywhere we go. We project the light, unveiling mysteries, the hidden things that Jesus Christ has done. One of the essence of the light is to project the real life that Christ has given to everyone who is born again. So I think that's how the name and the logo came about. Talking about the mandate of the church, it started. The first mandate, I think I've explained a little bit about the first mandate, the liberation mandate. The liberation mandate started from way 2014, but it was endorsed and assigned 2019. Then 2020, it was commissioned. And the liberation mandate talks about the scripture, Isaiah chapter 57, verse 14, talks about Micah chapter 2, verse 13. Then the second mandate speaks about the kingship and the priesthood mandate. And this came also 2020. And the Lord keep emphasizing that this is what I've called you to do to the life of the people. That I have given them a life. And many Christians are not living this life. And the Lord gave me a scripture, Revelation chapter 5 verse 10, that speaks about He has made us kings and priests. And the Lord took me also. And so I was like, okay, God, You've made us kings and priests. So what is this life? And the Lord said, go to verse 12. So I went to Revelation chapter 5 verse 12 and I found out the sevenfold. And I looked at it and the Lord said, this is the sevenfold mandate of the church. It talks about power. It talks about glory. It talks about blessings. It talks about wealth. It talks about honor. It talks about power. It talks about strength. And the Lord says, this is the sevenfold mandate I have given to the church. And He said, run with this and ensure that this is being made manifest to every life that come in contact with this ministry. And the third mandate is the mandate of standing out, standing tall. So the first one is more like what we have been called to do to the people, to bring them out, to snatch them out from the pit of hell. Then the second mandate is to introduce them to the life that Christ has died for. Then the third mandate speaks of the manifestation of that life, which talks about standing out and standing tall. I think the Lord started speaking about this from 2021, started telling me the life of standing out and standing tall. Then 2022, the Lord told me, He said, I have made this a mandate to the commission, that this is the life everyone must manifest. They must stand out and they must stand tall. And the Lord gave me a scripture, which is the book of Daniel. So that's where the three mandates came out from. Well, the truth is, the Lord has given us a vision. We are a people of vision. The first 2 years of the ministry, God gave us a clear vision of the church. God gave us a direction and a system and a plan on how to get to that place. And I think I remember one of the words the Lord said to me, He said, at the base of this church, that there's going to be a 200,000 seater capacity, that we accommodate 200 people, like an indoor building, that we accommodate 200 people, 200,000 people. So if you ask me, where do I see myself? I'll tell you, I see myself in that 200,000 capacity. But the truth is, that is not the end of Faith Refiners. That 200,000 God showed me in a vision and spoke to me about is just the beginning of Faith Refiners. So where I see Faith Refiners in this short time is the mandate, the vision God showed me, which is the 200,000 capacity. The secret behind my love for God is my heart. You know, not until you know how my heart beats for Christ, you will never know my secret. And this started, I've always loved God, but my definition for love was quite different. Not until I had an encounter and God showed me how I should love Him through obedience and my willingness to submit everything to Him. I think 2014, 2015, I had a strange vision. Now, as a young boy growing up, I was inspired by some few men of God. And I would lock myself and I'll be praying. I'll say, God, everywhere I go, they keep telling me that you're going to be wealthy, you're going to be wealthy. I said, God, I don't think I really need this wealth. What I need is I want to work for You. I want to serve You. I want You to use me. And one day the Lord spoke to me and the Lord said, okay, I remember saying to God, I said, God, can we trade? Can I give You the wealth and You give me the ability to serve You, to be called by You, to be used by You? I consider it an honor to be used by You above wealth. So while I was negotiating the trading, that God take the wealth and give me the calling, the Lord said something to me. The Lord said, if I will use you, you have to die first. So I was like, okay, God, I think I'm ready to die. I thought at that moment it was the natural kind of death that every Christian should die to the flesh and all that, not knowing that it was the real death. So on this fateful evening, I was alone at home at 9:10. My spirit left my body and I found myself in heaven. And when I got to heaven, they took me to a place full of people, and all they were doing there is just worship. So at the beginning, I started worshiping, and the next thing I started shouting, I want to go back, I want to go back. And someone came to me and said, don't you like it here? I said, this is the most beautiful place I've ever seen. Well, what have I really done for God that should bring me here? I said, it's just too early to be here, that I want to really do something for God. So he said, so why do you want to go back to the earth? I said, I want to go back because I want to do something for God. I want to dedicate my life, my time to God. I want to work for God. So the person looked at me, and it took him a little bit of time, and he said, your request has been granted. Then the next thing, I saw myself descending from heaven, and suddenly my spirit came back to my body and I came back to life. And ever since then, my love for God, my time for God, everything just became different with me. I became a different person. Nothing became important to me other than just serving God and making God happy, pleasing God. And I also remember one of the strangest things that happens is that I had this encounter, 2020. And in that encounter, before then I've been studying the book of 1 Kings, and I've just been studying the Solomon, and I was wondering, how did Solomon get to ask God for those things? And the Holy Spirit said to me, he was the one behind that. And I said, wow, Holy Spirit, I want you to be making decisions for me then. Then I heard a voice, a clear, audible voice, say to me, ask me anything in this world in the order of Solomon. And I thought, what an opportunity. I said, God, anything? And I said, Holy Spirit, I don't know what I want. Search my heart and tell me what should I ask. And I heard the Holy Spirit say to me, love. Loving God is the greatest. So I said, God, I have the answer. And I said, David loved you. You call him the man after your heart. Abraham loved you. You call him your friend. I said, I want a double portion. I want to love you the way David and Abraham love you combined. And after that, I went to bed and I had this vision. And in the vision, I saw the heavens open and I saw rain falling. And when I woke up, I heard a voice that said to me, what you have asked God is an open heaven. And I was like, no, I didn't ask for an open heaven. I said, love. And I heard the Holy Spirit say to me, you told God you want to love him. He said, the result of what you have asked God is that you said your heavens should be permanently open. So I think if you asked me, I received the grace that day to love God. And I've never looked back. I've loved God above everything. And nothing is too big for me to give up for God. But I know it's not by my strength, because the Bible says not by might, not by power, but by the Spirit. So my love for God is the result of the help of the Holy Spirit in me. First, I want to say thank you to every Faith Refiners Church Worldwide members for believing in this vision. Because when we started, many, you know what I'm saying, many doubted. But we have proven over and over and over and over again that this is not a man's mandate, but it's a mandate from God. So I want to thank every Faith Refiners member who were there from the beginning, who later joined, and those who will join in the future. I want to say this is a blessing to be in this house. The Lord called this house the house of blessing. It's a house of liberation. It's a house of lights. It's a kingship house and a priesthood house. This is where destiny is redefined. In Faith Refiners, the true image of Christ is revealed. The glorified Christ. And I want to say thank you for your patience. Thank you for your love. Thank you for your encouragement, your faithfulness, your dedication. From 2020 to 2022, when this ministry started, it was a huge sacrifice. Praying all night, praying, fasting became like everybody was fasting and praying over this mandate. The word of God keeps moving and all that. You never relent. You give your best, and the help of the Holy Spirit was there to help every one of us. I just want to say thank you all. Thank you, thank you, thank you. And I want to say this. I've seen how many of you have grown with faith. Because I remember the Lord clearly said to me when I asked, how do we present this mandate? What is the vehicle that we run this mandate? And the Lord told me, with the vision He showed me, the word of faith. Today I have seen every one of you manifesting faith in strange ways. Of a truth, this mandate is from God. I want to say the Lord bless you all. It's a season of open heaven. And God is not speaking to the church alone, because you guys are actually the church. So I want to say to every one of you, welcome to your open heaven. May you begin to experience the open heaven of God from this day. And may this mandate speak in your life. May you become a reflector of this mandate. Thank you, every one of you. The Lord bless you all. The Lord strengthen every one of you. God bless you.